Hello, everyone. Welcome to the devotional from Soldiers of the Cross. Let's begin in prayer. Heavenly Father, I come before your holy presence, and I thank you so much for this beautiful day that you have given us. Thank you for your loving kindness and your mercy that is new every single morning. Father, I thank you for being a good God, a good friend, a father to the fatherless. Thank you for sending your Holy Spirit to comfort us in our times of sorrows and to guide us through the darkness that we face each and every day. Father, where would we be without your Holy Spirit? Where would we be without your guidance and your direction? I thank you, Father God, for being so real and tangible in our lives. Thank you, Lord, for the blessing of the provision that you give us every single day, that's according to your riches and your glory. I thank you, Father God, that we are never without, that we have just enough of what we need. And when we start to lack, you provide. Father, I thank you and I praise you for you being faithful, even when sometimes we are not so faithful. Father, thank you for your word. Thank you for this time that we can spend just a few moments every single day in your word and listening to an antidote or a story, Lord, that helps us to make the word of God applicable to our lives. Teach us something in this devotional today. Guide us and direct us. Father, thank you for never leaving us alone in our time of sickness and our time of sorrow and our time of needing and our time of wanting. Father, you are always there with us, and I thank you and I praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Today's devotional is titled, Just because there are many does not mean they are not wrong. It was written by Nataldes Gonzalez and translated by Nelson Berries. Is taken from the book Table of Faith, page 174. Our biblical base today comes from John chapter 6, verses 65 through 68. So says the word of God. And he said, Therefore, I have said to you that no one can come to me unless he has been granted to him by my Father. From that time, many of his disciples went back and walked with him no more. Then Jesus said to the 12, Do you also want to go away? But Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Amen. May we be blessed by the reading of the scripture. Sometimes we agree with something, not as a result of reasoning, but for the simple fact that the majority is in favor of that something. But be careful. This could be a mistake. Let's analyze these cases in which the majority supported a totally wrong decision. There were more who stayed in Sodom and Gomorrah, more in the group of those who continually murmured in the desert, more of those who said that the promised land was not good. There were more among those who left after Jesus told them what they had to do to follow him. There were more in the group who wanted the crucifixion of Jesus. The few may not be wrong, just as the many may not be right. Better to analyze before choosing which side to be on and what decision to make. The crowd is not an effective signal to determine what is right in a given situation. The best way to know what is right is to ask your Maker and scrutinize His will revealed in His word. In Him, you will always find the truth, the blessed path. Amen. My brothers and sisters, How very true is this? We see it in society every single day. Society says, do this and it's okay. But the word of God says it is not. That is not God's will for you. But if we follow the masses, if we follow the big group, we will be wrong and we will be stepping out of the path of righteousness. Just because so many of the crowd say that it is right does not mean that they are right. It could very well mean that they are wrong. Remember, the path to heaven is very narrow. Very few people can follow it. So remember, if everybody's saying one thing is good, make sure you scrutinize it and you compare it with the Word of God. Put it in fasting and prayer if you need to. Ask God's guidance, because if we ask Him for wisdom and guidance, He will give it to us. My brothers and sisters, just because there are many does not mean that they are not wrong. Amen. May the Lord receive the honor and the glory.
There's a church in the valley by the wildwood, a lovely place in the dale. No spot is so near to my childhood as the little brown church in the
Amen. What a beautiful song. And now, my brothers and sisters, I invite you to check out the YouTube channel SCC English Ministry for our daily Bible reading. And now we ask that the blessed love of God, the grace and peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the companion and communion of the Holy Spirit, our great counselor, be with all of his children now and forever. Amen. My brothers and sisters, I pray that you have a wonderful day from your sister in Christ, Lisa Hernandez.